كيف تكفرون بالله؟ كيف تكفرون بالله وكنتم أمواتا فأحياكم؟
فرعون, the evil of فرعون. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us about Ma'ashitat bint Fir'aun, the hairdresser of the daughter of Fir'aun. And when we say the daughter of Fir'aun, we're talking about someone who is filthy just like her father. Someone who is taking advantage of the dhulm of her father. And Ma'ashitat bint Fir'aun, you want to see reality. Just as we saw the woman who was going into what she thought was going to be her dreams, we see here the working woman. The single mom. She used to do, literally her only job was to dress the hair of the daughter of Fir'aun. Every night she goes to her children. The only time she sees her children is when she goes and she takes to her children the food for the day. That's the only time she sees her children. The working single mom. And one day, she drops the comb. And she says, Bismillah, in the name of Allah. And the daughter of Fir'aun says, What did you say? She said, Bismillah, in the name of Allah. Bismillah, you mean my father? No. Bismillah, the Rabb of me, the Rabb of your father, the Rabb of you, and the Rabb of me, and the Rabb of all of the worlds. And she goes and she tells her father. And listen to how cruel Fir'aun is. Fir'aun brings this woman in front of him, in front of his entire army. And he says to her, what did you say? She said, I believe in Allah, my Lord, and your Lord, and the Lord of your daughter, and the Lord of all of the worlds. Now think about it, when she's making this statement, she's not the wife of Fir'aun. The wife of Fir'aun might have had a chance to get away from all of this. She, on the other hand, has no chance. She's just the hairdresser of his daughter. She's got nothing going for her to get her out of this situation. But she believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Fir'aun wants to torture this woman. Now we know, and I want all of us to think about this, especially for the mothers here. You would rather die than seeing your children die. And Fir'aun knows how to torture this woman. He's not just going to kill her. Fir'aun orders the army, his army, to go to her home and bring her children in front of her. And you can imagine what those children are going through. Whenever the army of Fir'aun reaches the house, they're thinking it's mom coming home to bring them the food for the night, to spend the night with them. But instead, it's the army of Fir'aun coming to drag them out, abusing them, to take them to their place of death. And you know what that's like for a mother. All of her children are dragged in front of her. And they're calling out to her, calling out her name, asking for help, and she can't do anything about it. Will you go back on your faith now? Absolutely not. And Fir'aun orders for each and every single one of her children to be burned and massacred right in front of her own two eyes. Think about that. All of us with children. She still didn't commit kufr. And when it came time for her, she made one request. She said to Fir'aun, لَقَدْ حُرِمْتْ I was forbidden in this world from the suhbah of my family, from the companionship of my family. فَلَا تُفَارِقْنَا فِي الْآخِرَةِ Don't make distance between us in the Akhirah. So whenever you kill me, take my bones and their bones, فَجْعَلْهُمْ فِي كَفْنٍ وَاحِدٍ Put them in one single kafan. Let us all be buried together. And Fir'aun says, you have that. And once she's killed, once she's massacred, her bones are put with her children. Now here's the beauty of this. We saw one woman, Asiya, radiallahu ta'ala anha, who saw her palace in Al-Jannah. The woman who thought that she was going into the relationship of her dreams, but she gave it up for something better with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now we see the working mom who never really tasted the sweetness of this dunya. And when we listen to these stories, we think nothing but tragedy. But you know what? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam confirms to us that when Jibreel alayhi salam was taking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through the heavens, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smelled a sweet scent. He said, Ya Jibreel, ma hadhihi ar-ra'ihatu tayyiba. What is this beautiful scent that I'm smelling? And Jibreel alayhi salam says, this is the scent, the hanut, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes to us. When the person dies, when the righteous soul dies, the angels come, the angel of death approaches him. In the long hadith of Al-Bara radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the angel of death comes to him. And he sees the angels coming down from the heavens with his kafan from Al-Jannah, with the smell of hanut from Al-Jannah, the perfume of Al-Jannah. And they say to that soul, or he says to that soul, أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسَ الطَّيِّبَةِ, O pure soul, أُخْرُجِي إِلَى رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ, come out to the mercy of Allah and His ridwan and His pleasure. Go ahead and come out. It's okay. Come out. There is something better waiting for you. And imagine, over 2,000 years later, the scent of that hanut from that woman was still sweet. And the Prophet ﷺ could still smell that scent in the heavens. Now, dear